This video is going to be really dense, but I promise you if you watch the entire thing, you will understand the following. What OpenCore is, how OpenCore works, why it works the way it does, and how OpenCore Legacy Patcher fits in with OpenCore. Since we have so much to cover, let's just get right into this. If you're watching this video, you're probably aware of OpenCore and OpenCore Legacy Patcher, but a little bit hazy on what the difference is and what they actually do. OpenCore is a bootloader, which is a term you've probably heard thrown around but not really explained, and we'll get to that. In short, OpenCore lets you run macOS on old Macs that are no longer supported by Apple and hardware that was never supported by Apple, like Hackintoshes. This video is a high-level overview so you can understand how OpenCore works and what OpenCore Legacy Patcher is. Before we get further, I just want to say there is a written version of this guide in the description of the video. In years past, when users wanted to run macOS on unsupported Macs, they had turned to modifying the operating system, the most common being pre-configured scripts like DOSDUDE1. These weren't perfect as you generally had to reapply them each time you updated the OS, no matter how small the update. Even a security update could render your Mac unbootable until repatched. This process was simple to do until it was not. Here's what happened. Over time, macOS has evolved to be more closed at the system level. This kicked off when Apple started following the trend of signed code in 2009 with the introduction of Snow Leopard. Signed code allows the OS to verify the identity of the software developer and ensures that the application has not been tampered with or modified since it was signed. This evolved in many ways, but most important is the modern usage of integrity protection, which exists in macOS as system integrity protection, introduced in 10.11 El Capitan. SIP, or system integrity protection, restricts the actions of the root user slash privileged processes that can be performed on critical system files and folders. To translate all that back into human speak, a rogue application will have a much tougher time hacking your OS as it doesn't have permission to do so. Also, integrity protection exists in the file system itself in APFS with metadata integrity protection, which uses cryptographic verification of metadata, which helps prevent tampering and protects against malware attempts to modify the system. The system itself now exists on a separate partition within the APFS container that is read-only during normal operation. All of this makes macOS a lot less likely to be infected with OS-level malware. Apple, in more recent releases, has deprecated Kexts, small modules of code designed to extend functionality of the macOS kernel and other system components, such as device drivers or file systems. Kexts, aka kernel extensions, are very powerful, thus they're a potential vector for malware. Of course, the focus on security has complicated modifying macOS by third parties. However, some very smart programmers and hackers devised impressive solutions. Meanwhile, on the Hackintosh side of things, users who wanted to run macOS on PC hardware had created a thriving software scene. Clover became the preferred and essential method of installing macOS on unsupported hardware. Clover was a bootloader and could inject Kexts into macOS. A bootloader is a piece of software that is responsible for loading the operating system kernel and initializing hardware devices during the boot process. We're going to dig into this a bit more in a minute. Clover was essential but has shortcomings regarding security, compatibility, configuration, and generally required additional patching. Hackintosh users and owners of unsupported Macs both faced a similar problem when trying to run macOS on unsupported hardware. A system update could break their entire setups, and until certain hacks and patches were reapplied. Obviously, accidentally updating your computer and having it not be able to boot is kind of a problem. OpenCore was developed as a way to fix these issues for both unsupported Macs and Hackintoshes, relying on its ability to inject changes as part of the boot process rather than modifying the OS itself. The advantage is the OS would be left intact without requiring altering of most of the security settings or patching and hacking the OS. The advantage is pretty clear. If you happen to update your computer, no problems. Or less problems. OpenCore uses a feature called Kext injection. When OpenCore boots the macOS kernel, it scans the system for all available Kexts and injects them into the kernel as needed. This allows users to add support for hardware devices that aren't natively supported by macOS or to modify the system behavior in various ways. OpenCore also uses the concept of Kext patches to modify the behavior of existing Kexts or to patch the macOS kernel itself. Clover also supported this as well, but OpenCore's methods are improved. Kext patches are small snippets of code that are applied to Kexts or the kernel at boot time, which can be used to modify the system behavior or to add support for additional hardware components. When the computer boots, OpenCore acts as middleware for the UEFI or EFI on the computer, a standard for computer BIOS that macOS uses. OpenCore loads its own firmware and presents the user with a bootloader graphical user interface, allowing the user to select their desired operating system. If the user boots macOS, it performs pre-checks and prepares for booting by prepping necessary modification, then loads the macOS kernel into memory and modifies it with the kernel patches and modifications and loads Kext for additional hardware support or system modifications. Once done, OpenCore hands over the control to the OS and booting proceeds as normal. To summarize, each time you boot macOS with OpenCore, it is modifying macOS on the fly, meaning you can update your operating system without worrying about losing patches or lowering your security settings. OpenCore is fairly complicated to configure, thus users would often share the configs for various hardware setups. For example, a very popular configuration for the classic Mac Pro users was Martin Lowe's OpenCore Configurations. This worked very well for users whose hardware matched or resembled the hardware the preconfig was targeting, as it created a template for other users to follow and edit. While this worked, it required a fair amount of technical know-how, reading and research, especially if your hardware differed in a significant way, such as a different GPU or network interface. OpenCore Legacy Patcher aimed to make this a point-and-click experience. OpenCore Legacy Patcher is a community-driven project based on OpenCore designed with old Macs specifically in mind. OpenCore Legacy Patcher is a graphical user interface that automates installing OpenCore on Macs that Apple no longer supports. Unlike PCs that come with an exceptionally wide range of configurations, Apple's product line is exceptionally small. This makes it predictable for OpenCore Legacy Patcher developers to create configurations for users based on the hardware it detects rather than the user modifying OpenCore configurations themselves. And of course, power users can modify OpenCore manually after using OpenCore Legacy Patcher. With a few short steps, a user can install OpenCore on an old Mac, allowing them to run recent versions of macOS on hardware that Apple has elected to no longer support. Apple doesn't make its money on old hardware, thus habitually drops support even if the hardware is quite capable of providing a pleasant user experience. Apple's yearly OS updates have slowly required more and more developer support for Apple security features and also have depreciated older technologies at a pretty fast clip. The end result is an older copy of macOS may not support the latest and greatest software, even as crucial as a web browser that works with modern web standards. In contrast, Windows has a much longer support window and with less frequent overhauls. While this is totally a personal opinion, it makes me realize the value of a paid OS update model, as it seems to be the case for Windows and longer-term support.
Okay, you made it through all of that. So let's go through and quickly summarize it so you can get on with the rest of your day.
OpenCore is the backbone for providing support for older computers. OpenCore Legacy Patcher is the utility to configure and install OpenCore in a very user-friendly way. OpenCore is a bootloader specifically designed to work with Apple's current security paradigm and avoids modifying the OS stored on the boot volume. It instead applies the patches on the fly and during the boot sequence. If you'd like to learn more about OpenCore, I've created a video about rescuing a Mac Pro 2008 from storage and installing OpenCore on it. I also created a 5-minute tutorial on the process of installing OpenCore using OpenCore Legacy Patcher, and I've created an OpenCore playlist in my YouTube channel for future OpenCore videos.